talking points about what you can share?
I mean, it gave me a few really general vague ones.
So we got to talk about season two then, huh?
Yeah.
Well, Octavia had an incredible arc last season. I mean, she became this full-on warrior. It was just badass. How much fun was that for you?
Oh, I mean, it was such an honor to play her and to see the girl that she was in season one to the warrior she's become in season two. I have had so much fun playing Octavia in comparison to the two seasons. I have had a lot of fun learning how to sword fight and throw that one on the resume.
Which is your weapon of choice right now?
Definitely the sword. Yeah. You know, I like to shoot pool and bars a lot, so.
No axe work?
That can double it. You know, if anything ever goes down, I'm ready.
Yeah. What were a couple of your, do you think Octavia's defining moments of season two?
Oh, probably the fight, that huge fight where she, you know, kept getting, her ass fed to her. That was a lot of fun to shoot that scene. And to learn, I did that entire scene myself. It was much longer. They ended up chopping it down quite a bit because, just a man beating up a woman that bad on television is obviously frowned upon for valid reasons. So they chopped it down, but I was so disappointed because it was such a cool fight. That was so much fun. That was my most proud moment.
Do you think? Oh, go ahead.
How much training goes into your character? Because it's really physical.
Yeah. A lot of training has gone in. Because I didn't know how to use a sword before, other than like a steak knife, you know, at the dinner table.
Does Octavia look up to Clarke at this point? Does she consider her still her leader, or is she kind of just doing her own thing at this point?
Octavia and Clarke are definitely at odds since she forgot to give Octavia the memo about the bomb dropping on Tondisi and letting me stay there or die. I think she's getting, the leadership position that she's in is so overwhelming because, again, these are such young people that have had to grow up so quick. And we all need to be constantly reminded where we came from, for sure. And loyalty. Come on, girl, that was brutal.
So that even goes into season three?
Pardon me?
That even goes into season three, the kind of animosity?
Yeah, you're going to see Clarke and Octavia come together, but they definitely have some unresolved issues to have.
Being in her own, what have you brought from your own personal life to sort of transition into being a young adult?
You know, well, I'm getting older too, as this is going on, so I think that's freaking inevitable. It's just been really amazing to play this character that has changed so drastically, and I almost forget until I'm reminded, because the 100 is coming out in France and England and all these places all over the world, and season two isn't out yet. So I'm getting, social media blast of like, oh, a sassy little girl. And I'm like, just wait. Nothing is ever what it seems.
So what's going on with Octavia and Lincoln that's coming up? Are they going to on the same page as far as their relationship right now?
No. I know this in season three. Octavia finally found her place with the treasure room. And she worked so hard to earn that position with Indra. And Lincoln is going to veer off in another direction. She's going to have to remind him, give his head a shake about where he came from.
Is she going to fight for him?
I mean, they're constantly making these epic romantic sacrifices for one another. You know, it's the Romeo and Juliet syndrome. Yeah, whatever happened to that in real life? Yeah.
So there's no chance maybe for Jasper, because now that Maya's out of the picture.
I know, he's so bent about the Maya thing, poor little Jasper.
Yeah. Well, maybe
your character's so much part of the rounder, and it feels like you sort of are able to see both sides, because coming down in this time, people, they aren't necessarily very nice. How are you guys sort of working with the next season?
The
kids act like children.